So, you know, I believe we choose our battles based off of our self-worth. People say choose your battles wisely. Well, you will choose to battle a lot of things that you feel like you have to because you feel like you don't have a choice. You feel like you don't have any other choice. For instance, in my landscaping business for years, I did shit for clients that I didn't want to do, that I hated doing. I knew I hated it, and I did it because I felt like I didn't have any other choice and I needed the money so bad, right? Because I didn't understand that there's this thing called marketing and advertising, that you can make your phone ring off the hook and then literally pick and choose what customers you want and don't want. There's all these options all over the place, and if you have tunnel vision and you only see what's right in front of you, like you're nearsighted, then you can't see all the opportunity all over the place. That's everywhere. So you just keep taking all these little opportunities that aren't even right for you, that aren't even aligned with your core values, because you feel like you don't have a choice. But here's the really dope part. When your self-worth goes up, it's like once in a while you'll score a little jackpot or something amazing will happen in your life where you surprise yourself and you'll be like, did I really do that? When that happens, your self-worth and your self-esteem goes up, and now you have a choice. You can say that was just a fluke, and that'll probably never happen again. Or you can upgrade your identity. I've really been up on this setting boundaries and creating minimums and thresholds in your life for things that you will and will not tolerate. It's a saying that I love. It's you deserve what you tolerate. If you keep tolerating stupid shit and letting people walk all over you, you deserve it, right? But if you learn how to say no, no, and there's no residue, and hear the word no with no residue, you hear no and say no with no residue, then you can walk a lot more free. You stand in your own square and you don't let people push you around. So face your fears. I've got a lot of fears. So that's the next thing, is the Fab Five. What are the five people around you that you associate with the most? What's their mindset? What's their level of success? Do they hold you accountable? Do they let you know when you're out of place or you're being a little bitch? Those are good friends, the ones that stand by you. They stand by your side and they don't have any agendas. I always thought I was too fucking old. When I was 17, I was like, I'm too old. When I was 21, I'm like, I should have did this when I was 17. When I was 24, I was like, man, when I was 21. And it kept going on and on. When I turned 30, I wished I was 24 again. When I turned 35, I thought I was too old. I'm 37, I realize I'm young as shit. I'm young as shit, I'm 37. Being a broke kid with dreams, growing up on welfare around a bunch of negative people, you can develop this thought process that you feel like you're worthless and you're unworthy of success. And then you feel guilty that if you achieve it, that people are gonna think you're selfish and that all you care about is money. But what happens is when you get around successful people, they never criticize you and say all the weird stuff that people that are in the victim mindset say. But if you just keep trying and trying and trying and bulldozing and you don't give up, eventually, little by little, things are gonna, it's gonna break apart and you're gonna keep breaking freer and freer and freer, and eventually you'll start getting your way, and then you pick up momentum, and the next thing you know, you're a fucking steamroller and you just bulldoze whatever's in front of you in a positive way. You know, you don't ever bulldoze other people or walk on other people. That'd give you a bad reputation. But what's interesting is results are what make you excited. When you get results, that's what increases your motivation and your self-esteem. You go from making 10 grand a year to 10 grand a month. And you go from making 20 grand a year to 20 grand a month. Then you go from making 30 grand a year to 30 grand a month, right? You think it's impossible, but it's not fucking impossible, because I watched this shit happen in my own life. And it's not all profit yet, but I've made $36,000 of revenue in 1 month. Dude, I went from having no income sources to just one source of income to 13 different sources of income. And I still find myself comparing myself to my friends that are fucking doing way better than me, saying, oh, I fucking suck. I can't believe what they're doing. But when you look hindsight in your life and you look at how far you've actually come, man, you've come a long way. It's something to be proud of. One of the healthiest things that you can do is take a breath, become fond of your past, let go of the past, remember all the good times, revisit your past. Take a car ride one day, go visit all the places you've lived, the park you used to swing at when you were a kid, and realize how far you've come. And then from that place you can integrate and realize where you're at right now and just go fucking crush it, dude. It literally comes down to a decision. A lot of decisions. You gotta be teachable, you gotta be coachable, you gotta be willing to learn, you gotta be able to take criticism from other people when it's constructive. Hang around people who are smart, successful, who have an open mind, who will put you in your place when you're being fucking stupid. The next thing I learned is a great question. Who am I becoming? Always ask yourself, am I coming somebody becoming a wuss, somebody who runs and sticks their head in the sand, or am I becoming a fucking warrior, somebody, am I becoming that person I dream of being one day, right? And then look at the other people who have already done that you want to do and say, you know what, if they're doing it, if they figure it out, I can do this. And then just be grateful for what you have and who you have. The secret to success is gratitude. So I got some work to do on myself, man, because a lot of times I'm ungrateful. I'm an ungrateful prick sometimes. Last night, my wife was upset about something. She asked me to do something and I threw a fit. Cause in my head, I'm like, I'm so busy. And then, you know what, I realized all the shit she does for me. And then I went and I apologized to her and she smiled.